Hey, space friends, what I'm geeking out about this week is a seafloor rover. Yeah, also known as a benthic rover. It's this really cool rover that is able to, well, rove around on the seafloor. I find this is a really cool thing that not many people know about, but should, because oftentimes we only see rovers, well, on Mars, but we don't really see them in the ocean. We might be used to seeing things like ROVs in the ocean, which are remotely operated vehicles that sort of hang off the sides of ships and can swim around and see a bunch of really cool stuff. And we definitely see a lot of cool stuff from ROVs. I actually was on a 3-week deep sea expedition a couple of years ago. That ship had a couple of ROVs on it. And through ROVs, you get to really just swim around and have fun and see stuff, and you kind of get to be in a mission control on a ship, all really cool things. But I've never really seen a rover on the sea floor before. And so there's actually a benthic rover that's been developed that's autonomous that can explore the sea floor and tell us so much more information. What's cool about this benthic rover is that it can go 6,000 meters below, 3.7 miles, so it can actually go really deep into the ocean, and it's autonomous. So essentially, you kind of have this autonomous mobile lab that can go deep into the ocean, way deeper than any human can, and can really explore the seafloor in a way that really hasn't been done before. This rover can not only go deep into the ocean, but it can stay there also for a long time, which is pretty useful. So it can actually stay in the ocean for up to 12 months, which is a really long time, and it's a time in which that rover can be doing a lot of really cool science. This particular rover is interesting because in air, it weighs over a ton, but they put a bunch of foam padding onto the rover so that once it's on the seafloor, it only weighs around 100 pounds or so. On top of that, they put caterpillar treading on it so that it doesn't really make that much of an impact to the seafloor and can kind of explore all of the critters and stuff that's down there, hopefully without disturbing it very much. The rover has a number of instruments, but two instruments caught my eye. One is that it has a fluorescence optical scanner. So it uses fluorescence to be able to actually look at the seafloor and detect chlorophyll by essentially looking for autofluorescence. Chlorophyll autofluoresces, which means it fluoresces on its own without adding any dyes to it. So this is actually a technique that you can use in microscopy. I've got a fluorescent scope right here, which is really fun to play around with. And what's really cool about fluorescence is that you can put so many things under a microscope, turn on the fluorescent light, and things will just light up all the time. Not everything autofluoresces, but a lot of things do, and chlorophyll is one of those. The other instrument on this rover that I really enjoy is that it's got an acoustic scanner using ultrasound, and it uses that to be able to detect all sorts of little creatures that are embedded in the seafloor up to 4 inches deep. Typically what the rover does is that it sets up shop in any given place on the seafloor and chills there for about 3 days while it does all this cool science, and then it roves on to another place on the seafloor and then does science at that new place for another 3 days. And with keeping it down in the ocean for up to 12 months, you can do so much cool science by looking for all these weird little creatures in the seafloor, looking for chlorophyll and all sorts of things. A lot of what the rover has been doing has been trying to study the carbon cycle at the seafloor. So essentially the supply and demand between creatures on the seafloor for carbon. All of this relates to climate change and better understanding carbon sequestration and other mechanisms that control how carbon is in our world. They've also been looking at how marine snow is distributed in the seafloor. And what they've discovered, at least so far in some of their studies, is that marine snow, which is dead debris of plants and animals and fish poop and all sorts of stuff, essentially all the random stuff that's kind of floating through the ocean that is used as fuel for other creatures and kind of accumulates at the bottom seafloor, they've discovered that marine snow can sometimes have huge pulses where a huge amount of marine snow just comes dumping onto the seafloor from time to time. They think this might be due to high winds, but they're still studying this. While carbon sequestration and carbon cycles are really important for understanding climate change and just how our Earth works, it's also important to understand how marine snow works. We have all this dead debris in the ocean that's so important for the life cycles of so many creatures there, and we don't understand it as well as we could. This benthic rover is one of a kind, at least for now. It was developed by MBARI, the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute. A couple of years ago, I took a tour of MBARI and really enjoyed it. It's a really, really cool place. Not only do they have all these scientists and engineers, but they actually build things. They kind of have a makerspace embedded in their institute, which is just really cool. The team that developed the benthic rover at MBARI was led by engineer Elena Sherman and marine biologist Ken Smith. This is what I love so much about multidisciplinary science. I love that this benthic rover came out from engineers teaming up with marine biologists to create something really cool in the world. I don't know of any other benthic rovers in development, but if you do, definitely leave a comment. I think they're really cool, and I think there should be more of them and more multidisciplinary collaborations like that, creating really cool feats of engineering like a benthic rover in the world. What I love most, as always, is that this shows that there are so many different ways to explore our world and the solar system and the universe and just everything. Always be exploring and always be exploring new ways of exploring. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you are totally enjoying these videos and you'd like to contribute, head on over to my Patreon campaign where you can get cool stuff and geek out with me there. Otherwise, I'll see you next time.